서울은 그렇고요. 이 건물의 지하에 있습니다.
안녕하세요. Hi. I'm Stefano. I'm the 대표님 of Soho Homebrew.
네, 그럼 저 안녕하세요. 저 이탈리아에서 온 소울 홈브루 대표님 스테파노이라고 합니다. 2013년에 소울 홈브루 창립했는데 그때 저 말고 그 미국 친구들이 다 창립하셨어요. 그때 제가 명품, 원래 저 명품 회사 가죽 장인으로 일했어요. 한국에서 일하러 왔어요. 그때 취미로만 그 소울 홈브루의 그 재료, 장비 그 구매하고 수제 맥주 집에 그 만들기 시작했어요. 어느 날에 제가 거기에 가서 대표님, 그때 그 대표님이 이름이 뭐지? 미츠 많아, 맞아. 미츠 조나탄 윌슨 만났는데, 아 지금 우리가 다시 미국에 가야 되니까 다 문 닫아야 돼요. 닫아야 된다고 말해줬어요. 그래서 제가 인수할 거예요. 그 갑자기 이렇게 인수할 거예요. 그러니까 좀 어떻게 말하지, 그 사업 좀 기회 보니까 좀 아까워서, 그것뿐만 아니라 저도 재료, 그때 재료 구매할 수 있는 그 맥주 재료 구매할 수 있는데 없었어요. 그래서 어차피 그 제가 맥주 계속 만들고 싶어서, 사업 잘 안 돼도 재료가 있을 거예요. So I talked to my wife and I told and asked her, I said, what do you think? And 그때, so that time she worked in the company and I work in the 명품 brand as 장인. So she said, okay, 해보십시오. I tried and we start very small. 지하 1층이었어요. 진짜. 지하 1층에 맞아요. 지하 1층 4개였어요. 지하 1층 4개, 제가 지하 2층. 진짜 동굴 투더지처럼. And we start working there really hard. And space was very small. So we thought if we want to expand the company like a little bit, 어떻게 해야 될지 고민이 많아서. 그럼 이사하자 라고 생각했어요. 그래서 우리가 여기에 왔어요. 2015년에. So we start importing, try to import from 미국, from Italy, from Canada, from 호주, from New Zealand. And so we start gathering a lot of products. We keep checking and trying them. And 약간 야근 시간이 약간 24시간 가끔 약간 잠 자기 않고 그냥 계속 일해요. 밤새고. And finally we got our result and we start having customer coming to us. And in the beginning we had only 10%, 20% Korean customer, 80% 외국인. But 점점 한국 손님들 좀 늘어졌어요. We got the trust from the customer. 신뢰 얻었어요. So that was the most hard time. Get the customer back and improve the quality and now we are here. So we are now established for probably 8 years. So I think it was a nice result. 지금 한국 손님들이 저기 새로운 제품들 다 좋아해요. 해보고 싶어요. 하고 싶어요. 그래서 제가 수입할 때는 많이 구매해요. 저 구매한 손님들이 많아요. 새로운 제품, 새로운 황류, 새로운 메가. Like they try a lot. So I can have a lot of feedback. It's really good. Because they want to see new. They want to experiment. Like they want to try something a little bit crazy. You know?
주 고객이
네, main frequent customers. 좀 다양한 곳, 다 여러 가지 있어요, 우리가. So we have a 양조장. We are directly importing 미국 몰트 from USA. So they, some customers really like USA malt, make American beers, American style beers. And we have kumbang, many kumbang, because we have also special price for kumbang, because we try to help each other a lot. We try to share together the product, and we have regular customers, homebrewers, 기본 수저 맥주 만드는 사람들이. We have Koreans and foreigners. So now foreigners, not so many, but actually they were same. Just the Korean customer improved many, so they grow up a lot. And maybe sometimes we have a university. 왜냐면 그 파리오의 그 lesson class 있으면, 아니면 brewing class 있어요. 지금 되게 유명해졌어요. 그 커피 브루잉 되게 화학 대학교. They develop a yeast fermentation. They want to know about, like, they want to learn about how brewing happens, like a interaction between yeast and the hops, and the yeast and the malt. So, like mainly is the four type: 양조장, 공방, 기본 손님, and 대학교.
1969년 이후 50년 만에 주세법이 개정됨과 동시에 코로나19 이후 홈술 트렌드까지 함께 겹치면서 국내 수제 맥주 업계는 더더욱 가파르게 성장하고 있다. 현재 국내 수제 맥주 시장의 규모는 2014년 기준 164억 원에서 2019년 880억 원으로 급성장하며 매년 20%에서 30% 정도가량 꾸준히 성장하고 있는 셈이다. 이 가파른 성장세에 힘입어 사람들은 맥주 자체에도 관심이 늘기 시작했는데 나만의 맥주를 만드는 소규모 양조에도 새로운 바람이 일어나기 시작했다.
그 시작 당시랑 비교해서 홈브루잉 인구가 그래요?
아, 그 yes, yes. I think the interest is grown. Not much. In the sense of quantity of customers, but I think like in the quality of beer. 그러니까 처음 시작했을 때 우리가 저 액체, 완전 액체 추출물 키트 많이 팔았어요. 그래서 그 저 DME, LME, liquid malt extract, dry malt extract 키트 많이 팔았는데 지금 완전 곡물, 부분 곡물 더 많이 팔려요. 그래서 손님들이 점점 옮겼어요. 그 완전 extract에서 to 완전 곡물. So they improve their skills. Yeah, their skills like 실력이 좀 늘었어요. 그래서 조금 더 제가 좀 자랑스러워. 예, 뿌듯해요. 예. 그 손님들이 특히 완전 추출물에서 완전 곡물가 바꿀 때 질문 많고 고민 많고 부담 많아요. 그래서 우리가 참 항상 좀 가르쳐 주고 천천히 we guide them. So we had a good result and that's why we are 뿌듯해요.
So, 그 what is the frequently question when you phone the world?
Usually we have a different type of question. Like we sell a lot of kit, 맥주 재료 kit. 그래서 손님들이 우리 웹사이트 보고 이 맥주가 엄청 맛있겠다고 생각해요. 그래서 그 맥주 재료 사고 집에 가서 설명서 보고 좀 어려운 생각보다 어려운데 생각해요. 그래서 우리 전화하고 이 맥주 어떻게 만드냐고 How can I make this beer? Or how can I get the best out of that? So we teach that. And the second main question, I think, people come in Saturday usually. We are open Saturday, so we are very busy here. But some customer come in and they ask us some question. They ask us like, which one do you think is the best yeast? Which one is the best hop? I would say to group up in one question. The main question would be, how can I make a tasty beer? You know, that's the main question. They all want to improve, that's all. That's the most important part, I think.
But actually, the advice is not your job. You're only selling.
Yeah, it's true. We are selling 재료, 우리 재료 팔아요. 그 우리가 공방 아니, 그러니까 공원 말고 그냥 교육, 그러니까
education center,
yeah, not education center. So it's really difficult sometimes because the customer they really needed some answer, but we don't have time because we have to pack. We have like a shopping mall, so we have like all the 그 배달 to do and 배송 and also customer calling for the 공방 they calling they are urgent, you know. Please send me very quickly. I need a bowl, I need a mold, I need a hop. I need a... So we are very busy. So sometimes we have to say sorry, we don't have time, and maybe try write email, you know, so we can slowly reply. Yeah. 사실 그렇게 어려운 손님이 없는데 그냥 가끔 설명 해줄 수 있는 손님. It's maybe I think two types. One is a person who start some. Brewery, some business, and they ask us for advice, like 추천해달라고 그 양조장 하고 싶은데 추천해달라고. So we don't know because we handle home brewing, all small size. We don't know how to make big size. And second type is sometimes customer come in, they have no patience. They go to the 수제 맥주집 수제 맥주 먹고 너무 맛있는데 좀 비싸요 라고 생각했는데 그래서 집에 만들까? 라고 생각해봤더니 여기 와서 제가 수제 맥주 집처럼 만들고 싶은데 더 빨리 하고 싶고 쉽게 하고 싶고 그래서 좀 도와주라고 그러고 사실 수제 맥주 빨리 하면 좀 힘들어 나오는 게 제대로 하려면 좀 시간이 걸려요. It's a natural product and it takes time. That's nothing I can do. So have to be try and try and make mistakes and keep trying. So it's really important that you must have a lot of patience when you make not just 수제 맥주 but any type of hobby or patience is rewarding. So they're not difficult, but we just don't have an answer for them sometimes.
The advice for the new customer is that to keep a patient, you know.
Oh yes, don't give. Yeah. I think if I have to say one answer is don't give up. Don't give up because I think 실수부터 배워야 되니까 실수해야 돼요. 그래서 좀 sounds like a 슬픈 소리, but even the beer doesn't come out as you want, I think you should keep doing and search for help. Go on the maybe some internet search. There is a lot of moim online. Ask a question, and you will if you keep doing if you keep persist in your try. Eventually will become like a. You will be able to make the best beer for yourself.
and separate brewing.
My favorite my favorite beer. It's a little bit difficult question because I like every beer. I like the season. 계절에 따라서 맥주 달라요. But if I have to choose one, I think my best beer is Hefeweizen because it's the most difficult to make. It's very difficult to make the correct real Hefeweizen with nice like a clove and estery and a kind of a banana flavor, you know, and the kind of a spotless and a bit hazy. It's really like a bit difficult to achieve. It's really a masterpiece. And so if I'm with the friends, 친구들과 그렇게 다니면 그 Hefeweizen 먹어요. 집에서 혼자 있으면 I like Belgian, Belgian Abbey, a Belgian heavy triple, Dubbel, or I like some heavy, like a aged. They call it in Europe we call like a meditation beers, because you drink on next to the fire and you think about, you know, you meditate yourself. So it's a meditation beer, I think. I call it meditation. You get drunk, but we call it meditation. Yeah.
So from my knowledge, Italy is a country of wine.
Yes.
And I'm just wondering how you got into a beer.
Beer making. Oh, 좋은 질문이네. The question is really interesting because I love wine. I love wine. I used to make wine when I was in Italy with my father, and I live in the Alps, close to the Alps. So there's a particular type of wine we make, and I had homemade wine, homemade. So when I came to Korea, I tried to make wine in Korea, but the 한국 보도 단도가 좀 그렇게 높지 않아요. 그래서 좀 와인 만들 때 민민하기보다 좀 도수가 그렇게 높지 않아서 항상 그 오염 생겨요. So becomes like a vinegar. 식초 되고 아니면 너무 떫어요. 그 맛이 너무 단 거부터 단 거에서 발효 다 끝나서 숙성 다 끝나고 또 떫어져요. So I thought like a wine is okay, but I cannot make wine like I wish. So I thought, how about I make beer? When I was in Italy, I used to drink Suja Mekchu because we have a Suja Mekchu. We don't have like American style. We have a more like a, we call it raw beer, like a 생맥주, like a, with a 효모 inside. And 호주에서 제가 조금 호주에 살았을 때, 15년 전에 Suja Mekchu 만들었는데, 그래서 I came to Korea and I thought, oh, I can make beer. Because 그때 2014년에 좀 수제 맥주 없었어요. 슈퍼마켓 이렇게 가면 그러니까 편의점 이마트 가면 좀 수제 맥주가 없었어요. 아예 없었어요. 그 경리당, I remember 경리당에 그 맥파이 있었어요. And 사게 and 약간 양조장에 there was only 맥파이. And the 맥파이 the beer was expensive. And I remember there was it's a very small place, so no. Every time beer run out, they run out of beers, and it was very far. So I thought I make home. So I start making the beer at home because there was no alternative to making 술. 막걸리 못 만들어요. 제가 막걸리 한두 번 만들었는데 다 실패, 완전 실패했어요. So I 너무 좋아했지만 막걸리 좋아하는데 그래서 I want to make my own. I want to make my own drink. So, I start making beer. Yes.
요즘에는 한 달에 몇 번 정도 양조하시는지?
저 바쁜 시즌이 있어요. 그 예를 들어서 지금 when summer finish, because during summer time people cannot make much beer. They have only one or two options because temperature 너무 날씨가 너무 더워서 맥주 잘 못 만들어요. 그래서 그 여름 끝나자마자 사람들이 맥주 만들어야 돼요. 왜냐하면 다 There's no leftover beer. They have like the cellar, the fridge is empty. So 9월 달 12월 달까지. 그러니까 우리 너무 바빠서 그 양조 잘 많이 아마 잘 못해요. 그래서 한 달 한 번, 두 번까지. But December until like maybe April, May, maybe 일주일 한 번 보통. 예. 왜냐면 지금 예를 들어서 지금 우리가 새로운 제품 들어가서 우리 좀 개발해야 돼요. 그 제품 들어가도 손님들이 어떻게 사용해야 될지 몰라요. 그래서 we have to give like introduce them. They come to the shop. We have the a small like a draft beer place. Then we give like a 시음. 제가 한 잔 따고 그러니까 드셔보세요라고 하는데 그래서 아 이런 맛이 나왔구나. 그래서 손님이 좀 자신감 좀 있어서 그러니까 구매하기 시작해요. So usually I brew for development from December to April, May, maybe once a week. And they 20L and they go very fast because people they like, enjoy. I give out, I finish, I prepare the 병이 파고 그 다음에 공방 한 두 병 주시고 그 대학교 한 두 병 주시고 그 손님도 그 포장할 때 아니면 그 여기 직접 오실 때 제가 한 병 두 병 친구들과 같이 나눠서 드세요 라고 그렇게 하면 되게 엄청 기분이 좋죠. 그래서 개발하면서 그 손님 좀 interest, we can build up the interest from the customer on the new product.
Here is our offline store, and as you can see, we have different products for making beer at home for home brewers, starting from the Pariotono, the fermenter. We have different size of fermenter, depends on which beer people want to make, the size of the beer. And then we have four different stage of brewing. For beginners, we have the extract kit, dry and liquid, and some cider extract, so people can make beer very easily for beginners. And we have for intermediate expert, we have the grains, so there is inside the grinding room, there will be some base malt. This is all the specialty malt that we use for making different type of beers. Then we have the for cleaning and sanitizing the pariotone and various equipment when you make the beer. Then we have on this corner here, we have all the hops. We have different type of hops, many different type of hops, almost 50, which are used for giving like the flavors and the aroma and bitterness to the beer. And then inside here we keep our yeast, which is very sensitive to the temperature, so we keep like one special fridge only for the yeast that has to stay on the on a certain temperature range. We also have a website, and our website is you can find searching Soul Homebrew on Naver, or you can Google Soul Homebrew, you will find us on the website. Or if you have time from 10 a.m. to 6 in the morning to 6 p.m. in the evening, you can come to our shop. We have also, as you can see, we have an offline Meijan, and is from Monday to Friday, and Saturday also we are open from 10 a.m. to 3 p.m. so feel free to come and visit us anytime.
And 우리 웹사이트에서 구경 좀 해보시면 you can see there is every product has a 설명서 in the Korean and 설명서 in English, so before buying anything you can decide like which product can be more suitable for your beer. And then also if you still not sure about which product, if you call us some in the working hours, some business hours, we can give also a little bit advice about like a, because sometimes like a, some malt, some yeast, I understand they sound almost the same. They like a, there is like a Belgian, the M21 is a wheat beer, and the M20 is German wheat, and people say what is different. It's a lot of differences. One is a Belgian style, one is a German style, and they have a different approach to the beer, so to the wort when you make it, so they work on different temperature, they work on they produce different kind of flavors, so there's a lot of different things. So sometimes customer they call us and we give some further explanation about that. Actually hops, 특히 hops hopes 생각보다 그렇게 쉽지 않아요. Hope 매년 알파산 그 쓴맛 달라져요, 바꿔요. And the flavors, the new hops developing every year. Now is a hop craze. Like every year they make new hops and they send us some hop samples. And some customer they come and they say, how is it? 예를 들어서 Sabro hop 어때요? 그 Sabro hop has a very nice coconut flavor. 어떻게 추출한 방법이 어떻게 해야 되냐고 그것도 되게 중요하죠. You can have the flavor in the hop, but if you don't put it in the beer, the flavor stays in the hops. So, like for example, that some particular process, like a cold crushing, and that when you cold crush the beer and you add the Sabro hops, you have a coconut flavor. But if you put the Sabro in the boiling on the last few minutes, you have some like a citrusy flavors. Some New Zealand hops like a YET, if you put them on the cold crushing, you have vanilla. But if you put them on the boiling or on the last time, like last few minutes, you have a tamung, you have a kule flavors. So these kind of things, it's not written on any books. Have to test them, and we try them, and then we can share with the customers.
As your foreigner, most difficult things in business in Korea, what is it?
Oh, that, yeah, as a foreigner, I never thought to have, I will have a business in another country. I had a business in Italy, family, but when I came to Korea, I came as just a 그냥 employee. I was just a 장인. So I thought life was good, and then I thought I always have a little bit of pride of what I do, and I thought I have some skills, and I thought I yagen a lot, so I might as well yagen for my business, you know. I thought so. Yagen 해야 되면 어차피 yagen 해야 되는데 그래서 제 사업 yagen 하면 제거 있을 거라고 생각했어요. So when I start, it was not difficult actually to start a business in Korea. There's a lot of help. I mean, government is very open on and is very thankful for that. But the learning the pop or the law, learning the rules, learning the importation law is very different from any other country like in Europe. So learning all that was a really big challenge for me. And the second, it was learning the trust from the people, from the customers and everything, because you know, people, they think, oh, he's a foreigner, he doesn't speak Korean, you know, how can I get this, some question, how can I get answer? So I improve I try to learn Korean, so I can see also the answer from Korean customer was really positive, because they think if I put the effort in learn the language, that means I really willing to do the job. So after I get the trust from the customer, I think that part was almost like overcome. So I think learning the language, learning the law, and get the trust from the customers, from Korean people, I think it was the three challenges that we had to face. 소울 홈브루 여기 우리가 서울 숲에 있어요. 그래서 홈브루 관심이 있으면 한번 찾아보세요. 감사합니다. 이 모기, I hate this 모기. 이제 부시 버리고 싶어.